percentage. Our next chapter for quantitative aptitude. First, let's understand the concept of percentage. Percent in Latin means per centum or by a hundred. So X percent means X hundredth, written as X percentage. To express X percent as a fraction, we have X percent equals to X by 100. Thus, 20% equals to 20 by 100 equals to 1 by 5. To express 1 by 5 as a percent, we have A by B equals to A by B into 100. Thus, 1 by 4 equals to 1 by 4 into 100%. That is equal to 25%. Now let's talk about percentage increase or decrease. If the price of a commodity increases by R percent, then the reduction in consumption so as not to increase the expenditure is R by 100 plus R into 100%. For example, agar kisi commodity ki price 10% jyada badh jati hai, to aapko uske consumption ko 9.09% ghatana padega. Matlab 9.09% consumption ab aapko कम करना पड़ेगा, जिससे कि जो ओवरऑल एक्सपेंडिचर आपका है वो सेम रहेगा. नाउ लेट्स सी प्राइस डिक्रीज. इफ द प्राइस ऑफ ए कमोडिटी डिक्रीजेस बाय आर परसेंट, देन द इंक्रीज इन कंजप्शन सो एज नॉट टू डिक्रीज द एक्सपेंडिचर इज आर बाय 100 माइनस आर इनटू 100%. मतलब फॉर एग्जांपल, अगर किसी कमोडिटी की प्राइस 10% घट जाती है, तो अब आपके पास मौका है कि उसी एक्सपेंडिचर ब्रैकेट के अंदर आप 11.1% उस कमोडिटी को अब ज्यादा कंज्यूम कर सकते हैं. नाउ लेट्स सी रिजल्ट्स ऑन पॉपुलेशन. लेट द पॉपुलेशन ऑफ ए टाउन बी पी नाउ एंड सपोज इट इंक्रीजेस एट द रेट ऑफ आर परसेंट पर एनम, देन पॉपुलेशन आफ्टर एन ईयर्स विल बी इक्वल टू पी इंटू 1 प्लस आर बाई 100 टू द पावर एन. एंड पॉपुलेशन before n years would have been p by 1 plus r by 100 to the power n. Now let's look at some results on depreciation. Let the present value of a machine be p. Suppose it depreciates at the rate of r percent per annum, then value of the machine after n years would be p whole into 1 minus r by 100 to the power n. And value of the machine before n years or n years ago will be P by 1 minus R by 100 to the power N. Now let's see results on comparison. If A equals to R percent more than B, then B is less than A by R by 100 plus R into 100%. And if A is R percent less than B, then B is more than A by R by 100 minus R into 100%. Now straight away look at some examples. Example 1. Two students appear at an exam. One of them secures 9 marks more than the other, and his marks was 56% of the sum of their marks. The mark obtained by them are, options are 39-30, 41-32, 42-33 or 44-34. The right option is option C, 42-33. Let's see how. As it is given that one secures 9 mark more than the other, then let their marks be x plus 9 and x. Then x plus 9 equals to 56 by 100 whole into x plus 9 plus x. Because it's given that x plus 9 will be 56% of both of their marks, so we'll add x plus n and x and find 56% of this value. So solving this equation, we are getting x equals to 33, and x plus 9 will be 33 plus 9, that is equal to 42. So the marks are 42 and 33. Second example, if A is x percent of y and B is y percent of x, then which of the following is true? Option A is smaller than B. Option B, A is greater than B. Option C, relationship between A and B cannot be determined. Option D, if x is smaller than y, then A is greater than B. Or option E, none of this. The right option is option E, none of this. Let's see how. Now first let's compare x percent of y and y percent of x. X percent of y equals to x by 100 into y. That is also equal to y by 100 into x. That is also equal to y percent of x. So x percent of y and y percent of x are equal. So A is also equal to B. Hence, none of the options match with this condition. Next question. If 20% of A equals to B, then B percent of 20 is the same as options are 4% of A, 5% of A, 20% of A, or option D, none of these. The answers are option A, 4% of A. Let's see how. Now, as it is given that 20% of A equals to B, that implies 20 by 100 into A equals to B. Then let's find B percent of 20. That is equal to B by 100 into 20. Now here, we'll replace the value of B with the result of the first equation. That is equal to 20 by 100A into 1 by 100 into 20. That is equal to 4 by 100A, which is equal to 4% of A. Next question. Two numbers A and B are such that the sum of 5% of A and 4% of B is 2/3 of the sum of 6% of A and 8% of B. Find the ratio of A and B. Options are 2:3, 1:1, 3:4, or 4:3. Right option is option D, 4:3. Let's see how. Now, as the condition is given that 5% of A and 4% of B is 2/3 of the sum of 6% of A and 8% of B, then straight away let's put this condition in equation. So that will be 5% of A plus 4% of B equals to 2/3 whole into 6% of A plus 8% of B. Then simplifying this, we are getting 5/100 into A plus 4/100 into B equals to 2/3 whole into 6/100 into A plus 8/100 into B. That is equal to 1/20 into A plus 1/25 into B equals to 1/25 into A plus 4/75 into B. Now let's bring all the A terms to one side and take the B terms to the other side. Taking A common, it becomes 1/100 A equals to 1/75 B. And by simplifying that, we are getting A by B equals to 100/75 or equal to 4/3. So required ratio is 4/3. Next question. A student multiplied a number by 3/5 instead of 5/3. What is the percentage error in the calculation? Options are 34%, 44%, 54%, or 64%. The right answer is option D, 64%. Let's see how. Let the number be x. Then error equals to 5/3 into x minus 3/5 into x. That is equal to 16/15 into x. That means the correct number minus the incorrect number. So the error percentage will be error by the correct number into 100. That will be 16x/15 into 3/5x into 100. That is equal to 64%. Next question. The population of a town increased from 1,75,000 to 2,62,500 in a decade. The average percent increase of population per year is, options are 4.37%, 5%, 6%, or 8.75%. The right answer is option B, 5%. Let's see how. Now the increase in 10 years equals to 2,62,500 minus 1,75,000. That is equal to 87,500. So the percentage in increase or increase percentage will be the increase by the original figure into 100. That is equal to 85,500 by 1,75,000 into 100. That is equal to 50%. So in 10 years, the population increases by 50%. So per year, the increase will be 50/10. So the required average is 50/10. That is equal to 5%.